big normal. Big numbers. Big numbers. Whole team counted, that's a big number. Big numbers. Big numbers. 100 million bag, that's a big number. Big numbers. Blue hunts. Whole team counted, that's a big number.
Hey everybody, it's the coach, and this is Monday Night.
All right, coach, first opened in 1999. There's a good look at First Energy Stadium here in Cleveland, Ohio. Tonight, we wrap up week three with a good Monday Nighter here between the Portland River Hogs and the Cleveland Browns.
Here we go, here we go.
So here come the Browns for their first drive on offense. And leading them, Charles, their quarterback, their field general.
And I liked what his head coach told us about him this week, that no matter what happens, whether he throws seven interceptions or seven touchdown passes, he's the same assertive leader in the huddle on each and every play. He can throw the seven interceptions, just blame the football, blame anything else, and still carry himself like he is the man.
It's like you, assertive in our production meetings.
Well, especially when we're talking about ordering dinner, ordering some snacks.
I was just going to say.
That's where I go.
First carry now for Kareem Hunt. And that is the kind of tackling they want to see all game, as he'll lose yardage to start things out. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. They'll run with Hunt on second down. And he'll take it forward for about five up to the 28-yard line. So here's the starting 11, and the human highlight reel, Odell Beckham Jr., watch out for him.
One of the few guys in the league that gets you and I out of our hotel rooms early to get here for pregame warm-ups and watch him go through his routine. He's absolutely amazing catching the football.
And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. That's a gain of nearly 40 yards on third and medium to pick up the first. So that changes things a bit. Here's a first and 10 all the way down at the 35. On first down, they'll run with Hunt. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
They'll set up to throw, and finding the tight end, Hooper. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. That is catch number 300 now for his NFL career. Second and 2. Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. If you're going to pass down here, you better get that in the end zone.
I agree with you totally. And as we both know, the field's already condensed. There's just not a lot of space. So you've got to create some by getting some people downfield into the end zone. If you want to throw it short, you've got to have some movement, some room.
And it's going to be caught for Brown's touchdown. Odell Beckham, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Browns take it right down the field and score on the opening drive. And the QB rating right now, sky high. 4 for 4 on that opening drive, and it ends with a touchdown pass.
Yeah, I don't know quite how to figure it out. I think I need my friends from MIT to come in and help me. I think 158.3 is the number one.
Yep, that's the
right? That's
mark.
The highest you can get. That's where he is. He'd like to continue on that pace.
This will be fielded at the 6. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. They'll run for the first time with Phillip Lindsay. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
Off the play fake. Herbert going deep downfield for Ross. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's 3rd down. After an incomplete pass on 2nd down, that'll leave him trying to convert on 3rd and 9. Back to throw. Herbert able to find Deion Kane. Complete.
I know at the end of games, coaches always tell us that no one play won or lost a game. But this seems pretty important early, doesn't it? Their ability to pick up that 1st down on 3rd down, I thought that was key.
Well, you're already in the hole after the touchdown on the other side. How will you respond? We talk about that a lot. And they responded pretty well there. You go 3 and out, I think you give up a lot of momentum. You get down 2 scores, could be an entirely different game.
So they've got a nice drive going now. They're in good shape. What's interesting to me is they're also in that spot of the field where you would take a shot. Do you change that up just because you're down a touchdown?
A good chance this is 4 down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now looking at a 3rd and 3. Now a handoff here to his running back. And a promising start as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. That's good for 9 yards as they convert on the 3rd down play. Had a chance to maybe limit them to 3 if they could have gotten that stop there, but a new set of downs.
And with a new set of downs, you got to take the mentality of the whole thing. Right now, everyone's looking at the offense and saying they've got the advantage. The best defenses just say, okay, new set of downs gives us another chance to make the play ourselves and maybe change things up.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. On 2nd down, a run with Lindsay. That he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of 1 yard, and it'll set up 3rd down. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Now play number 8 on this drive, and they need 9 yards to pick up the 1st on 3rd. Looking to throw. Herbert. A 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Mack Wilson. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line. To begin the drive, here's a handoff to Hunt. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. That's good for a Cleveland 1st down, an 11-yard pickup. His first carry of their 2nd drive, pretty solid. And, of course, remember back to their 1st drive, really strong throughout that one.
Not only is he getting good blocking up front, but how about his vision to find the holes? And he's seeing things before they even open and hurdling through him.
14 yards, and it's a Cleveland 1st down. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on 1st down. Back to throw. That's to his running back. It's Alvin Kamara. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big-time run, big-time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Look pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
This one quickly into the hands of Landry. No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be third
That's
down.
Brandon, just mark that under the category of just not successful. Trying to throw the ball, just didn't work on that one.
Completed it. No yardage. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Chris Jones in there to get him for a loss of 9 yards, and that also leads to fourth down.
Well, every now and then you just absolutely outguess yourself. Third and inches, and they decide not to run the ball, you end up seeing the end result.
The end result was not good. They elect to pass, and it backfires.
Let's go, Spud.
So here are visitors to take over on offense. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know what, a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done. Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
Going deep downfield for Ross. And this is going to wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong on the deep ball, and now they face a third down.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. And now the third down throw incomplete as well. And a tough ask here. They're going to go for it on fourth down and 9.
Let's go, D. Let's go.
Let's get this. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And this is incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Browns are going to get this thing back. Excellent field position.
I don't know why you would do that. It's almost guaranteed points the other way. I mean, I get it if it's a late game situation, maybe even fourth and inches. But boy, that's a huge risk to take.
Yeah, now they're set up in prime position going the other way. On second down now, it's Hunt. And they'll get this down to the 10. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. A reminder coming up just a few minutes from now, we'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
But you know you don't want to make a mistake in that area, so you make sure you make a smart throw. Throw it out towards the sidelines. If you overshoot your guy, so be it. It's just the incompletion that we saw there.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And this is caught. Touchdown, Cleveland.
Touchdown.
Odell Beckham with his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage. He's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, 2 touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. So here are visitors to take over on offense. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that zero off the board. Off play action. Herbert. This time for Smith, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 27. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Gets this to Kareem Hunt, his running back. 6 yards on the pickup, and it'll make it second down. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. Second and four. Quick hitter here, it's complete. He's got a first down and then some at midfield. And all the way down to the 25-yard line. Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime.
Let's go, D.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. Second and 14. Oh, he got position on him and he pulls it in. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. Goal line offense, something they've really been emphasizing in practice lately. Now they have a chance here to put all that hard work to use. No gain on the play there. It'll be second down. Now a second timeout called for by the defense as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. On second and goal, the lone man in the backfield is Hunt. Second and five. To the end zone, but it's incomplete. Something we haven't really seen much of from him, an incomplete pass.
Yeah, last week he finished at 70%. This week he's up over 80%. I don't know how you slow him down. Pass rush is usually the best way because a quarterback on his back usually can't complete a pass.
And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Nasir Adderley. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Set 18, Gator. Who draw Porter?
No.
Slip. Smith.
Hit it. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And it's knocked away and incomplete. John Ross, the one he was looking for. That'll bring up second down.
Another dangerous throw there, partner. I mean, he's already thrown two interceptions here in the first half. I don't know if you want to keep throwing up 50-50 balls and you've had that kind of lack of success.
Yeah, absolutely. Very well could have been a third interception in half number one.
Watch out.
Off the play fake. Herbert. And this is going to wind up a safety. And you know, the man who sat in my chair the last few years, he has a theory. These plays, these safeties, they're so rare. Maybe they should be worth more than two, maybe 4 points.
I think he's got a great point. I really do, Brandon. But I would go ahead and up it to six. I'm a former defender. Oh. To me, that's like scoring a touchdown.
Easy now. I'll go four. I don't know about six.
Come on. Come up to six.
A lot of points. Just 18 seconds remain till halftime as they come up on first and 10. They'll indeed try to run it out as they start on the ground. And an anxious moment or two there, but they do get him down. The Browns will quickly use their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. Back to throw now on first down. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Uchenna and Wosu got the sack there. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after this. And we will skip the highlight show this week. Get right back to this week three matchup. The Browns are going to get the second half kickoff, and they've got this lead as well as we are back and underway. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. So here are visitors to take over on offense. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. A huge play there on the screen pass. And even 40 yards.
They're still looking for their first touchdown of the game. And for a second, I thought they had it right there.
But looking on the sideline, it's finally good to see nods of approval. It's a welcome sign of life that this offense needed. Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down. So 3 plays already first and goal, and they are wasting little time. From the gun, Herbert, and it's caught. Touchdown, Deion Kane. His first touchdown of the new season as his guys are able to pull a bit closer. Now the offense will stay out there. They're going to line up and try for 2. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard and you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
The Cleveland offense ready to go. They had that first half lead, but they have been shut down here in this third quarter, so time to retool a bit.
And probably need to tap into that emotional vein that gets them back to really playing hard and effectively. Because a lot of times we think it's just play calls and this isn't working and they're shutting them down. Sometimes when you get a lead, you lose your edge. You don't play quite as hard. That's what they're looking for.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Chris Jones, his second sack of the night.
What a nice read and play by the defensive tackle. Never bought the play action fake. Went right for the quarterback and put him on the ground.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. He's going to look deep now for Landry. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. They don't get the hook up there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's a perfect word for it, precise, because if you're at 70% or better 2 weeks in a row, you have a job as long as you want one in this league, won't you? I mean, this phase is not just West Coast offense either. He's putting the ball downfield as well.
So here are visitors to take over on offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go up and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Offense.
So apparently some grabbing of the jersey there on the O-line.
Yeah, just look in the interior. And that's where the penalty occurred.
They're backed up here with a first and 20 now after the holding penalty. Back to throw. Herbert. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. That's a gain of 11. Would have been a first down if not for that penalty moments ago. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. Off play action. Herbert, he's going to float this one deep right side. This is caught inside the 15. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Well, what do you think? Maybe got away with one? I mean, he's thrown 2 picks already. That looked pretty dangerous.
And it had a little hang time on it, so what he needs to do right now, puck it out a little bit with his guy, because he went up and made a play on the football and kept him from potentially throwing that third interception. There was some trust in there. There was also some hope.
5 yards, a good run there, and now second and goal. Second and goal from inside the 5. Give him right around 4 on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on third and goal.
Hey, Charlie. Don't get nervous.
From the gun on third down. Herbert looking end zone, but it's incomplete. So they opted to pass for it on third and goal. Let's see what they do on fourth and goal.
Well, I think they threw it with the idea that if they didn't get it, they would go for it on fourth and goal. So they got another play in their pocket. They're going to have to call it right now. No field goal here.
Looking to throw. Herbert. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And the Browns are able to come up with a goal line stand. Now a play fake here on first down. Under pressure and down he goes in the end zone, and that's a safety. And Charles, at some point, you can't keep worrying about big play. Can this be perfect? You just have to get the ball out of the end zone.
And in the offensive huddle, that was discussed when they called the play. Just get out of the end zone. But you know what's interesting? A lot of the times in the defensive huddle, they actually call a set and then say at the end of it, get a safety. So it's preached, it's coached, it's thought about.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
Back to throw. Herbert, now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And it'll be third down.
I thought that wasn't a bad time to call the screen. I thought late game, down on the scoreboard, had to figure they were expecting a pass downfield.
Yeah, so the edge rushers, they're coming. That could have hit big. You're right. Good recognition defensively to snuff that one out. That's complete to John Ross. And he's going to come up a few yards short of the first. They get him to the ground at the 37. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. On fourth down, Herbert. And that is incomplete. The fourth down pass play doesn't work out. And the Browns are going to get this thing back. Excellent field position. Well, they've got the slim deficit, decided to go for it, hoping to keep the football score and erase that deficit. But, boy, deep in their own territory like that.
Let's just say that with that call, me and the head coach will agree to disagree. All right, but he knew he wanted to be aggressive there, as you pointed out. So I guarantee you, he told his defensive coordinator, have your guys up and ready. I'm going to go for it here. If we don't get it, just make sure they're ready to go out there and bail us out.
5 yards on first down, but now just a 1-yard pickup there on second. Now back to throw.
I know it was a gain, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there, because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of the play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held him to an okay game.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. Defense. Boy, tight game like this, fourth quarter, personal foul penalties, a no-no.
Yeah, we know the emotions are running high, the tensions are the same. Who can control them best could ultimately win it.
They go play action here on first down toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Once you get into the red zone and the safeties have less ground to cover, you better be quick with your delivery. Not much space to get a ball in there.
Yeah, when that field shrinks with those safeties, it's almost like there's a couple extra defenders out there, right?
It's certainly.
And he'll barrel his way into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. Alvin Kamara. His second touchdown on the season. And the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage. They'll look to throw. And he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by two more. And around the goal line, especially on two-point tries, sometimes the QB's best friend is that big target, the tight end.
I love how you described it, because you know he's going to have some length and some catch radius, as well as a big body to keep people away from the football.
Let's go!
So here are visitors to take over on offense. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. From the 21, it's second and 10.
Leo!
Check it backer.
Off the play fake. Herbert going deep downfield for Ross. That's caught inside the 20. And he takes this way down deep into Cleveland territory. A big play there. 68 yards. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Second down and inches. That's what they wanted. And it's caught. Touchdown. Deion Kane. His second touchdown of the night. As his guys are back within a single score.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? You know, one by land, two by sea. He didn't mention air because right now we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's two touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
And, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that in the broadcast.
You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
This fielded at the 2. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Browns drive about to get started. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have 3 timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit. And you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it 3 times and punt it, you've got another thing coming.
Yeah, and by the way, also the 2-minute warning in play, so essentially 4 timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here.
Now, this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here. Looking to throw. He finds Beckham complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 13 yards to pick up there. Good for a Cleveland first. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10.
Ready.
On the counter, Hunt. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. Now the defense will burn their 3rd and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. You'd have to think likely another running play coming here, 2nd and 11. They stay on the ground again, it's Hunt. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. So here we go, Charles, 3rd down. Any chance you're throwing?
I don't think so. I think you got to keep the clock rolling here.
And indeed, they will keep it on the ground. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4th.
It's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that, got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
And he is out of bounds here. So a change of possession here on the punt. And control of the football, switching hands here with very little time remaining in this contest. So here are visitors to take over on offense. Critical condition here, obviously. Got to hope to get something quick right and then maybe take that shot deep.
And once they do take the big shot, you've got to worry on defense. Of course, no one getting behind the defense and make it an easy throw. But nowadays, it's not just the ball being tipped in the air and people in the end zone in a cluster. It's that guy that's short in the end zone who comes up and ends up making the play because he goes unguarded. So there's a lot to think about if you're playing defense in this situation.
We'll see if they can cover all their bases.
Shift.
Go on.
Back to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Miles Garrett in there to make the sack on what will be the final act in this ball game.
Well, we saw a close game that kept us on the edge of our seats down to that final whistle. And right before that final whistle, defense with one last exclamation mark there getting the sack to end it.
I love how you phrased it because we were waiting to see what would happen. Obviously, we thought something would happen downfield. Instead, it happens in the offensive backfield, and that's your ball game.